Hey, it's Kelly from Muddy Beards. You might be wondering what I'm doing under here. Changing out my transmission fluid.
So I'm out driving my Jeep around right now, testing out my new cooling system. Just replaced that radiator with the aluminum radiator from eBay. Gonna be changing out my transmission fluid, hoping to get rid of the synchro issue that I have in shifting into second gear and shifting into third gear. My synchros are pretty worn out in my AX15 transmission. I'm sure everybody who has a Jeep, you guys probably already know this or are having the same issue with the AX15, maybe the AX5, with it grinding into the gears, the synchros not, they're getting worn out. You've beaten it up like I have. The part number for the AX15 transmission for the factory fluid right now is just 10W30. And so you can just go to your auto parts store, it's so cheap, just replace the 10W30. That's what I did probably 3 years ago. 10W30 is not the greatest on synchros. Doesn't really help with the shifting. It does okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna replace it with Synchromesh. It's a little expensive. It's like between $8 and $10 a quart, but I'm gonna give it a try and see if that helps my synchros shift a little bit better.
So there's lots of different fluids that this transmission can take, and it works just fine. You got regular just gear oil, you got red line transmission fluid, and you got Synchromesh, you got 10W30. There's all kinds of fluids that this transmission works with and people have success with. So use whatever you want, probably doesn't really matter too much. But I'm trying to get my synchros to shift a little bit smoother because it's been bugging me for quite a long time. This is the Valvoline version, Pennzoil makes some. There's actual GM Synchromesh. So you always want to open the fill first. Oh, it's not bad. Just in case it doesn't come off and then you're going to be stuck with no fluid in your transmission. There's my fill and my drain. I'm actually gonna try and catch some of it in this just to see what it looks like, to see how much brass and whatever's in there. And I always use a license plate. Man, I was trying not to make a mess. Oh well. So this is what I drained that I caught. You can see there is some brass in there, a little bit. There's no big chunks or anything, but it's not actually that bad. And I'm definitely just gonna be covering this whole shot here, but gotta get to the other side. Let's shimmy over here. Oh, yeah. There gonna be enough room? I don't know. Yeah. Stick my finger on it. You can get a pump or something, make your life easier, but I think I have one, but I don't feel like looking for it. This is the hard way. Just do yourself a favor and get a pump. Or if you have one, just find it. But I'm already under here and I don't want to get out because I'm lazy. And it says it takes 3.3 quarts and I'm at pretty much exactly 3 quarts. Okay. Now it's starting to come out, so we know we are 100% full. Take my ratchet and tighten it up. And this is all, you don't want to over tighten these either, because you're never going to get them apart if you tighten them too much. Okay, that's it.
I'm here at Evans Creek ORV park, and I've driven my Jeep all the way here on the street, and we're pretty much done wheeling for the day. And I gotta say, the Synchromesh fluid in my AX15 is definitely an upgrade, and I would definitely recommend it. Now, it's not perfect. It still has a little bit of a grind every once in a while, a little bit of a difficulty getting in and out of gear, but the transmission is just really beat up. A lot of wheeling miles and a lot of years of abuse. So if you want to spend $30 and upgrade your transmission fluid to Synchromesh, I would recommend it. You guys, make sure that you subscribe to our channel, like our videos, check us out on social media, Instagram, Facebook. And if you have any comments, make sure you leave them down below. Let us know what you think. And check out this view and Robbie eating his lunch. Dr. Pepper and Cheez-Its. Classic Robbie. All right, guys, we'll see you on the trail.